Good morning, everyone. Welcome to another video for YouTube as a demo on landscapes. My name is Cliff Austin. Welcome, welcome, welcome. If you like my art, please check out cliffaustin.com. And these videos are on YouTube. And the Curtis Art Center is linking them for free demos, free classes for a while. And we'll be starting some online classes there soon. Also check out Mary Williams Fine Arts Gallery in Boulder, Colorado. She is doing a 30 for 30 April Showers, May Flowers, where you get a 30% discount for these troubled times. And today I'm working on a white canvas, which is pretty unusual for me. I normally work on a dark canvas. It's a 9x12. Single primed acrylic, inexpensive canvas, and we're going to see how this goes. So I start with a grid, a tic-tac-toe grid, thirds. You know, we learned the rule of thirds back in grade school, and that still holds today. So we have our thirds. And then we're just going to mark out some places. Just do some basic outline for getting our proportions of our shapes in the proper places. What I want to do is mark out our major shapes. So we know and can keep our proportions. It also helps us to get our design concepts going, which is really, really important. The way we arrange these shapes will create an interesting design. The way we arrange those shapes in a manner that creates a good composition so that the eye stays in the painting keeps the interest of the viewer and tells a good story. So what I've got is a abstract going on here, these verticals against this horizontal with some lines that are going to be, it looks pretty interesting. So I'm going to start with my darks. And I use ultramarine and burnt umber as a basis for my darks. And I'm going to add some sap green to it. So burnt umber to me is really like a dark orange. And orange and green are nice combinations. And I'm going to use a chip brush. Just to get some of these shapes going on in there. That's pretty dark. That's all right. It's looking pretty cool. I've added some ultramarine blue to that pile and puddle. And let's see how that works out. I really want to get the these big shapes in. All I'm trying to do is get the major dark shapes going. Not interested in any detail yet. Really like to see how these dark shapes interact with the medium shapes. Kind of like that in there. And it just gets interspersed all over up through there. That's interesting. Now we can start moving into some of these lighter shapes. Nice abstract so far. And the lighter shapes to me look like they're quite, wow, pretty bright. They are drastically high key values. Right in here. Right in here. Something like that. Even some really high key colors right in there. Interesting. And we can move into modifying some of these shapes, making them look more interesting, like there's some really nice blues going on right in here. Is that too dark? It might be. But we'll see. And we've got these gray purples, which are really interesting. So to gray a purple, you add just a touch of yellow. It's complement. And then it goes in here. Really light value. That's interesting. So I guess for a rule of thumb, you can say, don't be boring. Let's move this over just a little bit more, like that. Okay. Now I'll switch to a smaller brush and try and get a little bit more information going on in there. And I'll switch to a small brush just to get a little bit more information. And so I want to modify the darks. I've got all my shapes in there. I want to modify my darks just to give some indication of where some of these should be a little bit more pronounced. So information kind of means detail. And so just going to outline a few little pieces and parts here where I want just a little bit more information, kind of like guidelines of where things are going to go. Just a guideline here and there. Don't want to get too specific too soon. Just like that. So how do you know when to get specific? That's a good question. Not one that's easily answered. So what I do is I just go back and forth. I like to start with the big shapes and make those big shapes a little bit more defined. So it's kind of like at this point working on edges. Background there. I'll try and beef that color up just a little bit. So things that go in the background are lighter, cooler, and softer. So I want to make sure that this is not too bright, but still interesting. Get some of these sky holes coming through here in this shape. Make sure I got these darks dark enough in here. That edge just a little bit. And we have the lights. Well, these are so much fun. This is kind of like where the magic happens for me. So let's see. We've got some lights going on in here. This is like painting on the negative shapes. So we know where the sky holes are. Kind of defines the tree branches a little bit. Every shape, or just about every shape, has got a hard edge and a soft edge, or a defined edge and a non-defined edge. So this would be a defined edge. Start shaping these nice little tree trunks. Kind of like that. And where there's a dark shape, there's a light shape. So let's do some of that. We're just refining and placing interesting shapes next to other interesting shapes. There's a light side and a shadow side. Things going on in here. Because it's a light panel and wet paint, I can scrape using the point of my palette knife. Can you hear that? I'm just scraping pieces and parts off. Let's put some light in the trees there a little bit. So I've taken some cadmium yellow and mixed it with my pile of dark green and blue. And we just got to put some light in there somewhere, like right in here is a bit of light. Definitely on this side. Lots of light coming through here, like that. And it splashes all across here, and it shows itself right in here. That's all there is to it. You just keep adding pieces and parts here and there until you get to the result that you want. There's going to be a big swatch of light. Big piece of light that goes right through there. I'm using just a rubber eraser. Cheap Joe's white rubber eraser. And I'm just taking excess paint off. Wipeout technique. It's really a lot of fun. If you're interested, text me or leave a comment and I will do a whole demo on just wipeout techniques. You can use a wipeout tool as well. Some interesting shapes in there. bramble and bushes right in here. These are really interesting trees because they've got branches going everywhere. And we're getting close to the end of my time. So this is a good start. I will finish this off camera and post it on Instagram and Facebook. And please leave your comments if you like. Any requests, that would be cool too. And check out cliffaustin.com. Please look at Mary Williams Fine Arts in Boulder. Wonderful gallery, great art, great artists. And check out Curtis Art Center in Greenwood Village, where we will be doing some online classes. Thank you, and have a great, great day.